Assalamualaikum. Today I am taking class 2, subject EVS. Look at the picture, children. Can you observe anything here? What you will observe? Yes. Here, elephant is sitting on the tree. Camel is in the water. Goat is flying. Rabbit is flying. And the giraffe is staying in the cave. Is it right? It is all? No, it is all wrong. Why do you think they are wrong? Yes, because goat can't fly. The camel can't swim. The giraffe can't live in the cave. And the elephant can't climb the trees. So now let us learn more about animals. Animals around us. There are many animals in the world. Some animals such as lions, tigers live on land. Some animals such as monkeys and squirrels live on trees. Some animals such as fish and starfish live in water. Some animals such as bees, butterflies and birds can fly. There are some animals like frogs that can live in both water and on land. Do you see all these animals around you? What will you do if you suddenly see a lion roaming on the street instead of cow or the dog? Definitely you're all running to your home, right? So you're all run to your home. So where it stay? It stays in jungle, in the forest. So let us learn about wild animals now. What are wild animals? Which are wild animals? Animals such as lions, tigers, bears, giraffes, zebras, deer, rhinoceros and hippopotamus, among the other animals, live in jungles. We do not find them in our neighborhood. These animals are called wild animals. Domestic animals. Domestic animals means the animals which are useful to us. Farm animals and pet animals are together called domestic animals. Farm animals means the animals which are useful to us. Pet animals means the animals live with us at home. They become a part of our family. These animals are called pet animals. Such as dogs, cats, rabbits, parrots and goldfish are often kept at home. These are called pet animals. Farm animals. Farm animals means animals are very useful to us. Such as cow, bulls, buffaloes, hens, goats and sheep are kept on a farm. These animals are called farm animals. See, these animals help us in many ways. Bullocks. Bullocks plow our fields and pull carts. The bullocks used to dig and turn over a field. You can observe in the fields, in villages, they are using the bullocks. Camels, horses and mules also carry goods and people on their backs. They also pull carts. Some wild animals such as elephant can be tamed. Tamed means the wild animals to whom we can control. It's called tamed. Elephants carry loads and take us from one place to another. We get many things from animals. From cow we will get milk. From ducks and hen we will get eggs. From honey we will get honey. From sheep we will get wool. From donkey we will get, the donkeys are useful to carry our load. Now we will learn about animal homes. Like how we need home to live, in the same way animals also need a house to live. Animals who live in jungles make or find homes for themselves. On the other hand, we make homes for the animals that live on our farms or at our homes. A rabbit makes a burrow. Burrow for itself. But we make a hutch for a pet rabbit. Most pet dogs stay with us at home. But a dog that guards the animals on a farm lives in a kennel. A sheep lives in a pen. A squirrel lives in a hole. A horse lives in a stable. A cow lives in a shed. We should care for animals and treat them well. So you have to complete practice time in A, B, C in your textbook and D main in your classwork. Thank you.